as we're down to 48 seconds left on the power play here for the Jens. Not too much going on for them. They just had their best chance. That's going to be dumped in by Stoner, and we're going to get a whistle. And I believe it's going to be an offside.
That was a great offensive possession by the Generals. A 1-2 right there. The shot on goal. It was just a little far to the right. Good stop there by the Hattricks, and the rebound as well. They just couldn't capitalize on that second chance point.
I guess maybe they called an icing, but I thought they dumped it in after the red line, so I'm not exactly sure. As a shot on net gets deflected in front, as Dent bodies off. Now Deacon Moore backhands it around. And we got another penalty coming up here. So we're going to play 4-on-4 for 21 seconds. And I believe it's going to be a roughing penalty. That's going to be Dylan Dent. They're going to give him a slash. So not what the Jens wanted here, as they nullify their power play, and it's going to be 4-on-4, as we said, for 21 seconds with 14:49 left to go here in the first period. No score.
And so far, it's a very strong defensive game by both teams, making sure that the puck does not go in goal, and I'm hoping to see more of that in the future periods.
Have plenty of layers, as now here come the Jens. Entering the zone there, shot in was Matthew Coe. But to no avail, as the Hattricks look to break out of their own end. Now Kovalev on the wing. Kovalev cross ice to Weber. And a shot in, I'm not sure who that was, but the net came off as he whiffed on it and fell down.
And for Rieger, he did not play for the Generals last game. It looked like some rest here, and we were uncertain with the start of warm-ups if he was going to be the starting goalie for the Generals, and it looks like he is in goal, and so it'll be interesting to see how he's going to play after that day of rest, and to see, because the Hattricks are coming out firing on all cylinders.
Absolutely, and it appears that the faceoff will come in the neutral zone, probably because the Hattricks player knocked the net off. Face off won by Weber. Dumped in Kovalev, and it goes off the stick. And a chance there from G. DeShepherd. So we'll have another face off in the neutral zone, this time to the left, right in front of the Jens bench. Weber on the draw against Sean Gorman. And then Hattricks win the draw again, and now a chance as they'll rim it around. Jumping on it there is Cullen. Cullen in the corner. Now Weber has it. He'll try to chip it to no avail as Deacon Moore knocked it out of harm's way, and the Jens will send it all the way down. With 50 seconds left to go here on the power play for the Hattricks, as they'll skate it through their own, through center ice rather, and another penalty coming here against the Generals, and a chance in front, they score! A great feed by Rogers. And that's going to be Luke Dubé who finishes it off for the Hattricks. So, and the worst part here for the Generals is that came on a delayed penalty. So now the Hattricks will have a power play in addition to that. And it was a tripping call.
Costly mistakes early on for the Generals that resulted in Dubé's goal. That's his second of the season. And the Hattricks coming out strong, even with, you know, having to sit outside as we waited in the other rink to see what was going to happen with the stanchions. And although they, with some rest, they look like they were ready to play, and Dubé with the goal there.
Yeah, well, it's going to be Nick Racker, I think, who took the tripping penalty. They're trying to sort it out right now. It's not going to be Racker. It's going to be Jacob Kaminsky. So, not the ideal start here for the Generals with 13:28 left to go in the first period. It's a 1-0 Hatricks lead on the goal by Dubé from Rogers. And it was a great play by Rogers to get it to him on a 2-on-1 down low. So the Gens are going to have to kill off another penalty here. And Donovan right off the bat will dump it in and chase. Rieger behind his net to play it. He'll wind it around. And the Gens will dump it all the way down. Hirschfeld out to play it. He'll rim it around. Donovan on the half wall. He'll chip it up. As Deacon Moore comes out with it, he'll dump it in on Hirschfeld. Hirschfeld backhands it around to Maustre. And now up the boards here. A giveaway. Here comes Clark. Clark with a shorthanded bid here. Forehand shot. Save Hirschfeld. The rebound. And he'll take a whistle. Great job there by Clark to get a shorthanded scoring chance.
Yeah, for Clark, like you said, he was shorthanded. It was just him by himself with two other hat trick defenders and the goalie. So, I mean, he was lucky to get a good shot there. It was a good look, but a great play by the hat tricks defensively.
Drew Schemmel on the faceoff against Weber for the hat tricks as Weber wins the draw. Kovalev behind his own net. Goes off the boards. Now Kovalev gets it back, trips it up the boards through the middle. And Keystone Kops there as two of the Gens collided. And the Gens look out of sorts here early in this one, but they do get a clear there with 50 seconds left to go on the penalty.
One thing to note, though, is that Jacob Kaminsky is the second most penalized player on the Generals team with now 61 total minutes that he's spent in the penalty.
Corner, cross ice, in front of tip, save Rieger, and the rebound trying to get out of harm's way as the Generals do, and they will send it all the way down the ice. A big clear there, Rieger coming up big as Hirschfeld will settle it down. As a pass up through the neutral zone, Kovalev can't handle it. Now it's in his feet, and a nice check there by Clark. And the puck goes all the way down. It was icing initially, but they wave it off as the puck slowed down. And so that will do it for the penalty. The Gens able to kill it off. Big kill there as they were down 1-0 and then had to kill off another penalty. Now the puck comes loose. For a second, the Gens had a chance to jump on it. And now the puck is out of the zone. A big collision there at center ice. And then a shot on net is gloved and held by Hirschfeld.
Now, Hirschfeld's been busy all day, it seems like, as the Generals been on that end of the ice. And luckily for him, he's having a strong defensive presence there at goalie with several saves on the day already.
Yeah, and it's a good thing, too, that he's getting a lot of action early, is because we mentioned he was probably trying to do his best to stay as warm as he could, having to wait for this delay. So for him, you probably want the action early.
And you really get that blood flowing, too.
Absolutely. And now the Gens back on their own end. As they'll jump on it, it's Dylan Dent. Now DeShepper, he'll chip it around. Now Morelli. Puck goes to center ice. Wallace looks, tries to send it in, but it hits a stick. And that'll be icing as DeShepper threw it all the way down.
On that play, it looked like Wallace just kind of hesitated a little bit, didn't know what to do with the puck, which ended up in that icing in the turnover there. But I mean, for him, he has to pull the trigger quickly here, especially in a fast-paced game like it is today. You can't really think about it too much.
10:34 left to go here in the first period. 1-0 Hatricks. Kovalev on the draw wins it, but the Gens get possession, and no icing as a hit, a hat trick, and now a collision behind the net. Bracker is looking for it. Holiday plays it around. Keeping it at the point is DeShepper. Now Kovalev on the forecheck. DeShepper has it. A nice pass there. Here's a chance here. Flying down the wing. Centering pass just out of the reach of Racker. And now a chance here. Moore. Oh, he's lost an edge, and now a chance here. 3-on-2. And oh, they couldn't settle the puck there. But they get it back, and now keeping it in is Lefkoff. Now at the half wall, throwing it in front. Rieger with a makes the save, and they'll take a whistle.
Even though he's allowed one goal, Rieger has been an important part of the defense here for the Generals. I mean, he's been really putting his body out there on several shots, and you know, even though one got by him, still as a goalie, you cannot let that really bother you too much, as you got to move on to the next play, and Rieger's done a really great job by doing that.
9:36 left to go here in the first. 1-0 Hattricks. It is Weber on the draw against Kaminsky, and Kaminsky wins it. Puck back to center ice. Firing one in, Rieger sticks it to the corner. Playing it around there, shipping it up the boards. Patrick's able to keep it in, a shot on net goes wide. Now the puck behind the net, Weber there with it. Troubles it out to the point. Now to the middle of the point, a long shot saved by Rieger, and the rebound knocked just wide. And now trying to get it out there for the Gens, but they couldn't, as Weber now across the ice, and what a shot, and they score! That's going to be Matthew Teräväinen with one heck of a shot. He goes almost bar down over Rieger, and the Hattricks have a 2-0 lead.
That's his sixth goal of the season, and that one was a really high goal there. And you know, Rieger, I was just saying how he can't let these bother him too much, but now it's a 2-0 lead for the Hattricks, and now the defensive game plan has to change for the Generals if they at least want to, you know, keep this within reach.
Yeah, not much support defensively so far for the Generals. They've been kind of sloppy in their own end. As the Gens try to battle back here from a 2-goal deficit with 8:39 left in the first period. Being outshot 9-7. Now the puck out to the point. Shot, that's blocked. And now back to get it is Kaminsky. Kaminsky being pressured. He'll take it around his own net. And ooh, almost a bad giveaway in front. And they'll have to jump back on it. Kaminsky will flip it up over. Now a chance for Gorman in the corner. Gorman rifles out in front. And the Gens back on it. Scramble for it there. Holiday is able to chip it up to the neutral zone, but the Gens dump it back in. Hirschfeld gloves it. He'll leave it behind his net for Wallace. And back to center ice. Dumping in is Dylan Dent. Pursuing there is Gorman. Now puck at the point. Now a chance here, and a whiff of a shot there, as DeShepherd will stay with it. And now here's a chance for the Gens. Centering pass in front, just out of the reach, and now a shot by Dylan Dent that goes just wide. DeShepherd from the point. He'll shoot it right into the gut of Hirschfeld, and he'll take another whistle.
Hirschfeld's been doing a great job for the Hattricks, and for the Generals, we mentioned in the pregame shows that they have a very strong first period presence. I mean, they're one of those teams that likes to come out firing early on, and even with the 9 shots on goal, they haven't had one to fall.
So it'll be on the faceoff here, Peyton Felix for the Gens against Kovalev. A chip in front, oh, and a save by Hirschfeld. He had to react quickly, and now a chance here the other way for the Hattricks. In alone, backhander, and he airmailed it over the net. Another great chance for the Hattricks, and lucky for them, he shoots it over the net. Rieger might have done enough there to bother him. But once again, the Gens need to pick it up here defensively.
Yeah, they certainly do. I mean, it's just been a little sloppy for them. I've been seeing a lot of the Generals players falling on the ice as they've been trying to do too much, I feel like, on the defensive end. I think they just need to really keep it simple and just stick to the original game plan that they had in the first few minutes before that first goal.
That was Misha Masarov who had the breakaway chance there. He just shot it, tried to go too high, and airmailed it as now the puck goes into the corner. Playing it around is Kamensky. And now Kamensky has a chance. Throws it into the corner. He got deflected out of play.
I think for the Generals, especially on these fast breaks, they just need to really just be controlled on these and just, you know, really feel the puck on that play and make sure that they can get the best shot that they can. And that probably was one of the better opportunities for the Generals right now.
So 6:34 left to go here in the first. 2-0 Hattricks. It'll be Drew Chamel on the draw against Weber. Dylan Weber wins the draw. But he gives it away in front, a chance. But there for the Hattricks to get it in a 3-on-2 chance here. Down the wing, and a good defensive play there by Kamensky. And the puck goes out to center, and the Hattricks will settle. Is Goodman now another chance here, and another whip shot as Rieger will take a whistle. And it seems like scoring chances are being given up left and right here for the Gens.
Now they really need to start capitalizing on a lot of these breakaway plays that they have. And you know, we see that with the Hattricks early on in this game, is that they're really taking advantage of these mismatch opportunities when it's 3-on-2 or 2-on-1, and the reason why they're up 2-0 early on.
Holiday wins a draw and rims it around. It's falling down there. Now Dylan Dent chasing back to get it, but he's beat out. And now the puck to the point, and it goes out of play. There's a blocked shot there. And I believe it was Oberon for the Gens.
Comparing it to last game, I mean, for the Hattricks, they had 3 goals in that opening period, and they have 2 right now, so the reason why I think their strong early presence might be able to help them out in this game.
Dylan Den on it. He's double-teamed in the corner by Holiday and Mastroni, and we're going to get a whistle and a penalty. And it looks like the Gens are going to be shorthanded again. It's going to be DeShepherd goes to the box. And it's going to be a cross-check. So 2 cross-checking penalties taken by the Generals in the first period. That's their third. Not a recipe for success, as they're going to have to kill off another penalty with 5:30 left to go here in the first period. Already down 2-0. The Gens able to win the draw. Puck is in the corner now. Rogers battling in there. And the Gens are able to get it out. And now a giveaway. And a great move by Peyton Felix. It's loose. Puck comes out to the point. And Kamensky will have to... This is delayed offside as Kamensky plays it over to Deacon Moore. Moore will just send it all the way down. Stick by Hirschfeld. He'll backhand it up the wall. Massar will skate it behind his own net. Madzi cross ice to Teräninen. Teräninen, the second goal scorer for the Hattricks. Kovalev tries to leave it off for Kolonen. Hattricks having some trouble getting out of their own end, as Deacon Moore will send it all the way down. So a strong penalty kill so far here for the Generals.
A
I really like this Hattrick's defense. I mean, they've completely shut out Deacon Moore and James Clark in this first period, and we haven't really seen those guys get a lot of action on the goal like they're accustomed to doing, and I think that's a really strong point for the Hattrick's today, and hoping to continue that in the future periods, is that might be a key to their success.
As Dylan Weber now will go into the corner, only 14 seconds left to go on the penalty, 3:40 left to go in the first period. Now a stretch pass into the zone, but it's going to be offside. So the faceoff will come to the neutral zone right in front of the Generals bench.
Great job by the Generals, really killing the penalty here and being able to get back to even here with, and they're, as they're shorthanded right now and waiting the faceoff in the neutral zone.
And that'll kill the penalty off. So the Gens back to full strength here. Back to 5-on-5 hockey. A big penalty kill. Very much needed. But now here comes another chance for the Hattrick's. Sending in front, but nobody there. And Kaczynski tries to get it out, but it's knocked down at the line. But now here comes Kaczynski. Kaczynski and Maltz. Maltz in front for Kaczynski out of his reach. But a shot in front. And it just came back out, but the Hattrick's jump on it. And now pressure in their own end, but back through center ice, Dylan Dent on it there. And sending it in on the goalie, Hirschfeld, as Kaminsky is in the corner. Now a shot from the point, goes just wide. Almost came right back out to Kaczynski, or Kaminsky rather, as Deacon Moore tries to not send it in, but it's knocked down and played all the way down here. No icing. As now here comes Clark, James Clark, building up speed through the neutral zone. Down the wing, pulls up and stop, looking in front there, and a shot on net, and Hirschfeld makes his reactionary save on Kaminsky.
James Clark, he was speeding down the ice on that play, and I thought he had a great look, but that pass was just too far out in front, and really, if they could have connected on that play, that could have been possibly a goal, and that would have been a great assist.
So Tyler Kaminsky on the faceoff. Loses it to Holiday, but gets it back. Throws it in front, looking for Clark, but it's sticked out of play by Hirschfeld. A good reactionary save there.
Looks like the Generals right now in this possession are really coming out firing on all around. I mean, they've been really putting a lot of pressure on the Hattrick's here, and it hasn't really worked out for them, but at one point today, I think it will.
Yeah, we haven't seen too many big scoring opportunities. They're getting pucks on net. There's a shot just out in front, just missing. Now Deacon Moore at the point. His shot. It's loose in the crease. Trying to find it was Hirschfeld. And it comes out. And is now a chance at 2-on-1. Weber tries to tip it to Donovan. Rieger comes out of his net and gets it out of harm's way. But Donovan sends it back in front. And it's sticked away there by Loftus. And now Clark in pursuit. But the Hattrick's Donovan will take it back into his own end, circling and leaves it off for the defenseman. And now back to center ice. Now building speed is Peyton Felix, but he gets knocked down as Clark plays it to Dylan Dent. Dent pulls up from the point, looking in front for Felix, just out of his reach. As DeShepherd keeps it in at the blue line, Weber then sends it out. And now a chance here. Hattrick's shot goes wide in the corner, it was blocked by Dent. And another shot gets blocked by Felix, as Levkov will send it in. And a giveaway is Dent almost gives it away to Kovalev. Now Rieger able to get it to DeShepherd as there's 30 seconds left to go in the first period. No icing. And the puck played up to center ice. Now Dylan Dent And DeShepper, who had been out there for a while now, as the puck goes back in to the corner, Levkov, the captain for the Hat-Tricks, will play it. And now here comes Kaminsky. In the corner. And play it out to center. Kaminsky gets it in, rifles it in, but that'll do it for the fiction. And we're underway here for the second period as Peyton Felix wins the draw. And the Jens will chase it back behind their own net. Nick Racker can't get it out of the zone. Levkov shoots one from the point. That goes out of play on the save from Rieger. So still right off the bat to start the second here. The Hat-Tricks are getting pucks on net in the offensive end.
Yeah, one thing is that they came out firing in the first period. And that was one thing we really noted in our pregame is that's what this team likes to do and fire early.
And Peyton Felix now. That ends it up to Pizzometti. As the puck couldn't be corralled by Rackers, he would have been in alone if he had gotten possession of that puck. Now the puck at center ice. Pizzometti gets down the wing. Throwing it up and out of play there is Oberne. So we'll have a whistle here. 19:20 left to go here in the first, or excuse me, in the second. 2-0 Hat-Tricks. Shots on goal are actually favoring the Jens right now, just not as many scoring chances. The favor of the Jens 14-11, but again, not as many scoring chances for the Generals. As Weber will win the draw for the Hat-Tricks. And Donovan chips it down and there'll be no icing. As a race for the puck there is Loftus. And now here comes Deacon Moore. He'll send it in on Hirschfeld and he'll be forced to take a whistle as he had Oberne in his kitchen.
Here we are with the Generals. I mean, they're coming in to this period down and they're really the backs up against the wall here. And I feel like they're playing very aggressive early on, trying to get that puck down to that side of the ice and trying to put the Hat-Tricks defense on their heels.
Now Moore puts a shoulder in to Donovan there. The puck rimmed around. Now battle for it on the half wall. Now here comes Donovan. He'll just send it in as Rieger tries to stop it for Deacon Moore, who has to go into the corner to chase it. And now some trouble behind their own net for the Jens.
He's got to get out.
Play it up the boards.
You have to get out of there. You cannot prevent the Hat-Tricks to getting that puck behind the net and possibly getting another goal out of it and extending their lead.
Absolutely. Now here comes James Clark flying down the wing. Takes it behind the net. Now throws it up to Dylan Dent at the point. Dent will shoot one. Gets deflected. Goes over the net wide off the glass in the corner. Now Kaminsky will knock it loose. As Deacon Moore gets tripped up, and there is going to be a penalty there. And it's going to be, I believe, Masser, who will go to the box for the Hat-Tricks. So a big opportunity here for the Jens to get back into the game as Deacon Moore draws the tripping call with 18:03 left to go here in the second period.
And this is going to be huge for the Generals. You need to capitalize on this power play, and this is where tides can change if they're able to get a goal out of this.
Yeah, this is a must-score power play at this point in the game and the way things have gone for the Jens. Peyton Felix wins the draw from some help from Pizzometti. Pizzometti looking for Kaminsky. Now Pizzometti has it back to the point and they'll play catch. Pizzometti back to Kaminsky. Puck comes loose in front as DeShepper had it on his stick, but he couldn't pull the trigger. And now Kaminsky will bring it back to center ice. He'll switch with DeShepper. DeShepper loops it, trying to build speed in his own zone. But now here comes Peyton Felix as he loses possession, but then jumps on it behind the net. Puck possession very important here on the power play as Felix will circle. He'll leave it off for Pizzometti. Pizzometti on the half wall. throws it to Kaminsky. Cross ice, looking in front, loose, and trying to jump on it was Pizzometti, but he couldn't quite get there, and it's knocked away by the hat tricks and all the way down. And Rieger will leave it off for Kaminsky, who's being trailed by Kovalev, and he picks his pocket. Not good puck management there from the Jens, as Kaminsky will now go behind his own net, trying to settle things down. He goes for a long stretch pass, looking for Racker. The Shepherd now gets it to Pizzometti. Pizzometti loses the puck, and the hat tricks try to send it all the way down, but it stays at center ice. Now Kaminsky jumps on it with 40 seconds approaching on the power play, and the Jens will take an icing, so they cannot get a change here.
Now, one thing that is kind of disappointing about this power play is the Generals have been really taking their time with it. They've been playing slow offensively as they're just playing pretty much catch with each other, passing the puck back and forth, and a risky play on their side, too, just leaving the puck there and nonchalantly just going to get it. So they need to pick up the pace here and be aggressive.
Weber wins the draw, but the Shepherd jumps on the puck. Kaminsky behind his own net, being pressured there in a giveaway. Almost. And the puck comes out in front. Weber almost jumps on. That was a near disaster for the Generals. And now Bacon will send it in on a delayed offside. And with 20 seconds left on the power play, DeShepherd will circle back. And now here comes James Clark flying down the wing. Looks in front for Oberon, and he couldn't get a stick on it. As the puck goes to the half wall. Now a shot in front. Oberon on the rebound. A save by Hirschfeld. The puck's loose, and the net comes off and a whistle. That might have been the best chance for the Generals today. Oberon wide open in front alone. Was looking for a tip initially. He tipped it, but the shot didn't have very much on it. You got to wonder if he wishes he kind of just possessed the puck. But he got another chance on the rebound.
Yeah, and there was two opportunities on that play for the Generals to get that goal and possibly capitalize on the power play. But within those 2 minutes, they only had three shots on goal. And I believe that they should have had a few more shots if within those 2 minutes to be aggressive. But they just kind of slowed it down and kind of played their own game and did not help them out in the long run.
Tyler Kaminsky and Carson Holliday on the faceoff. It's a stalemate, and the puck comes loose, and that will be the end of the power play for the Generals. There's now a 2-on-1 chance here. Holliday down the wing, a shot off the crossbar. And that one looked like it surprised Rieger a little bit. Looked like he might have been thinking pass, and the Jens dodge a bullet there as the puck goes in behind the net of the hat tricks, and now Levkov has it. Levkov lost the puck for a second there, but he's able to get it to his defense partner, Poshetsky. He'll send it around out of the reach of Levkov, and now James Clark in pursuit. And it's a battle for in the corner there. Puck comes out to the point. Oberon being hooked, no call. And a big hit in front by Kaminsky as he got over and they score! Kaminsky doing the dirty work in front. And it's going to be Nicholas Oberon who buries the goal for the Jens. It's 2-1.
That was a great job on that possession. They were aggressive on the net, and after getting the rebound, they were able to, were lucky enough to have a man right there to help them out and get the goal. And now we have ourselves a game, and looking forward to the rest of this game as it's going to be a close one down the stretch.
You got to love Tyler Kaminsky throwing his body around in front of the net, the big hit, and establishing position there. And then Oberon, the perfect spot, is able to bury that feed from Kaminsky, and we're going to get an icing here. With 14:51 left to go here in the second period, it is now 2-1 in favor of the hat tricks as the Generals getting on the board.
And that's Oberon's 17th goal on the season, so putting him up there, with Clark and Moore. So, I mean, this is a very talented Generals team, and they have a lot of high scores.
Chance there off the faceoff. It went just over the blocker's side of Rieger. Now the puck at center ice. And now here come the Jags, throwing it on net, and an easy save for Hirschfeld. As Drew Schmel was challenging him there. So the Jens starting to challenge Hirschfeld a little bit more, generating more scoring chances so far in this period.
Yeah, and since the start of the period, it doesn't seem like the Hatricks have gotten a shot on goal all period. I mean, for the last 6 minutes, it's been a straight defensive effort by the Generals, but also a very heavy offensive period for them.
Kaminsky's shot got deflected way up in the air. And now Kaczynski will dump it in. Oh, that's a tough one. You got Kaminsky and you got Kaczynski. Now Weber, he'll send it around, trying to get it out of the zone, but it's kept in there by the Jens. Now a centering pass as Gatz almost put that one home, just past the stick side of Hirschfeld, but it went wide.
Hirschfeld's had himself a very busy period. I mean, 7 shots in 7 minutes. So, I mean, they've been very busy on that offensive end. And for Hirschfeld, he's had a lot of action on his end. And it looks like Rieger, he's been very quiet on his side and well-deserved because, I mean, those two first goals early in the first period were very important for the Hatricks, but it looks like the Generals come back in the second.
And you can just tell how composed Trey Hirschfeld is in net there. He's a very positionally sound goaltender.
Yeah, even with all that action, he's been very composed, like you said, and very beneficial because, like you said, we mentioned earlier, is that it's a mind game for the goalie, and they have to be very, you know, aware of what is going on.
Now another shot from the point there. That was Loftus that threw it on the net. Now here come the Hatricks back the other way. Peyton Felix intercepts the pass. He'll chip it up the boards to no avail, looking for Racker. And Loftus gets it back. He'll chip it up. Puck is up in the air and then goes back into the general zone. Loftus goes D to D to Deacon Moore. Moore looking for Racker at center ice. Racker jumps on it. Now Peyton Felix. Racker. Into the corner. Now it's a battle for it behind the net. Loftus tries to backhand it in deep. Loftus throws it in front, but nobody there for the Jens. Levkov, the only one there for the Hatricks. And now a change, a line change there for the Hatricks. They had numbers back the other way, but trying to get off was Levkov, and now the puck goes into the corner. And now here's a chance for the speedy James Clark. Clark tries to pull it past Levkov, but he couldn't, and he's lost an edge. And now a chance the other way, and a great defensive play by Dylan Dent, and it's going to be a delayed offside. And now finally Levkov will get to make his change. Now Dent, cross ice, looking for Clark just out of his reach, and this is going to be icing. Good idea there by Dent. The puck just wouldn't sit flat for Clark.
I mean, that was a great possession. I mean, look at James Clark, his speed. He got down there very quickly. It just looked like his speed was just a little too much and lost control of the puck. And that would have been a very dangerous one-on-one if Clark did have control of the puck. And who knows what would have happened next after that.
So, Kovalev and Kaminsky on the draw. Kaminsky gets tossed, so James Clark's going to have to come in and take the draw. And Kovalev wins it. Now back to the point for Wallace. Wallace throws a flub shot on net, but now a turnaround shot that goes just wide. Rieger didn't see it until the last second there. And now Oberon carries it out, and now chance Oberon in front, a shot that goes off the glove of Hirschfeld. Another great pass by Kaminsky. And now DeShepard tries to pinch in. But now here's a chance the other way. Now Kovalev cross ice in front. Oh, what a save by Rieger. Oh, but they score right after. It's Madzi from the faceoff circle. I believe Rieger got a piece of that first chance with his stick, which was an incredible save. But then Ryan Madzi from the faceoff circle makes it a two-goal lead again for the Hatricks.
And they really capitalized off that rebound. I mean, Rieger did a great job on that first block, but he just wasn't quick enough to get back in position and set himself up, because that second shot came right after. And here we are now, as the Generals are down by two once again.
And correction, that's Cole Madsey, not Ryan Madsey. We got the goal there for the Patricks. Another chance in front. And a block there from the defenseman. So the Hatricks waking up after the Gens get on the board as they reestablish their two-goal lead. And now Weber gets it in there.
And for Mazzy, that's his fifth goal of the season. So putting him up there with the leaderboards for the Hatricks team. And they're really capitalizing on the offensive end, as it seemed like in the first part of the second period, it was all Generals on that one side of the ice, but now it's the Hatricks kind of flipping the tables here.
Big hit by Kaminsky. The Gens having some trouble getting out of their own zone here, as they finally do, but they're going to take an icing. 10:22 left to go here in the second period. Cole Madsey getting the third goal of the game for the Hatricks as they reestablish their two-goal lead.
Next few minutes are going to be very important for the Generals, because, you know, they're starting the draw at their side of the ice, and so their defense is going to really have to step up here big time.
Absolutely. As Ryan Wojciechowski will play it back for Levkov. As the Gens jump on it. Now Levkov back at his own end. Throws it through the middle. Now Mastromoni has a chance. Backhands one that goes off the toe of Rieger behind the net. And now here's Holiday on the giveaway. And a nice block by Kaminsky there. And now here comes Kaczynski. Gaining speed, crosses the line, a great move. Throws it in front just wide. Some great moves by Kaczynski there, but he couldn't finish it. As now the puck being battled for on the half wall, as Holiday will come out with it, and he'll just dump it down as the Hatricks will get a change here. Now Levkov being chased by Gratz. And a giveaway there. And now a chance beating out the icing by the Hatricks. As Pizzamenti now has it. He'll play for Deacon Moore behind his own net. And now a giveaway as Wojciechowski will dump it in. And now here's a chance for Pizzamenti. He's got Deacon Moore with him in the middle. Pizzamenti goes to the front, and Moore couldn't get the rebound. So another good chance for the Gens. They couldn't capitalize, as this will be an icing. And the Hatricks will catch a breather here.
Now, on 24 shots so far throughout, you know, this game, the Generals have been busy on that end trying to get the goals, but they haven't been able to connect only one time. And, you know, on that last play for the Generals, that opportunity that they had, it was just that second chance opportunity that just couldn't get in. And, you know, they have to be more on this side of the ice, and they've been more on the defensive end, kind of on their heels, having to play most of the part in the second period.
Payne Felix to the net, and a save by Hirschfeld. Felix jumps back on the puck. Throws it out to the point for shot. That's knocked away by the Hatricks. Coming on it is Loftus again. He'll send it in deep. Levkov chips it up the board. And a good keep in there by Loftus, but Peyton Felix couldn't corral it, and Rieger will come out and play it off the half wall. And now here's a chance for Pizzamenti, and he couldn't corral the puck. Deacon Moore gives it to Peyton Felix. He'll dump it in, and the Generals will get a change. Now a stretch pass here, but it's offside. So 7:48 left to go here in the second period, a 3-1 Hatricks lead.
and the Hat Tricks are certainly using that momentum from yesterday. I mean, in that game against the New England Sharks, they did not score in the second period whatsoever and weren't even allowed a shot. And today, they have one goal and two shots in only the second period. So a turn of events here for the Hat Tricks in only a day.
Now a chance, here's Clark, closes and shoots. It goes just wide over the net. So a giveaway leads to a great chance from James Clark, and he couldn't finish it off. That's got to have been the moral of the story so far this period for the Generals.
It certainly has. I mean, so many shot opportunities and more misses than makes, if anything. And James Clark, it's unlike him, really, because he has 16 goals on the season and one of the leading scorers here for the Generals.
And this will be another icing.
Seems like a very slow second period here for the Generals as they're taking their time on the offensive end, which isn't helping them out on the defense because they're backpedaling. It seems like every single possession that they have on offense to go right back into defense. So not something that you want to be getting used to, and you got to change sooner rather than later if you want to get back into this game.
And here comes another icing. So Wallace ices the puck this time. And the Gens will have yet another offensive zone faceoff to the right here of Trey Hirschfeld. 7:23 left to go here in the second. Kaminsky and Kovalev on the draw. It's a stalemate, and the Hat Tricks will come out with it. Kovalev chips it up the boards, and a big collision there. Dylan Dent put a good body there in to Mastromoni. Now Kovalev serpentining through his own end. And this will be another icing.
Only a matter of, you know, just under 30 seconds and we get another icing again. Not a lot of action here in the second period besides the goal by the Hat Tricks, but for the Generals, they really need to start picking up the pace here on the offensive end instead of, you know, playing so laid back and letting the offense and let the game coming to them. They need to start attacking and going towards the goal more rather than just staying back in the neutral zone.
Felix wins the draw, back to the point of shot. His wife, Pizzamenti, had it taken off his stick. Now here comes Kovalev in a 3-on-2 chance for the Hat Tricks. And that was just out of the reach. But Kovalev is now, he'll stay with it, throw it to the other side, but nobody there for the Hat Tricks. And Kaminsky will try to get it out, but a chance in front, and a great save by Rieger on Kovalev. And now another chance in front, and another big save by Rieger, and now a scrum in front of the net as some extra jawing going on as somebody there was poking at Rieger after he corralled the puck and the whistle was blown. So the Gens standing up for their netminder there.
Rightfully so, too. I mean, Rieger with two great saves there. Even then, those pucks were coming at him fast, too, back-to-back after the rebound. So, I mean, you got to stick up for one of your best goalies here on the team, Rieger, who's coming back since he rested the last game that the Generals played.
And it appears he might be getting a penalty here. I think Nick Racker's going to be going to the box for the Generals. And so it's going to be a 4-on-4 here, I think, as Misha Mishar is already in the box for the Hat Trick. So I think it's going to be even here. It might even be 5-on-5 due to the scrum ensuing after the whistle. As, you know, one of the unwritten rules of hockey is you don't touch the goaltender at all, especially after the whistle. And the Gens took exception to that. Nick Racker will be in the box.
And rightfully so, too. I mean, Racker stuck up for his teammate, and even though that's sending him to the box, nothing wrong with what I believe that what he did there, sticking up for Rieger after some great saves that he's had all game long.
And Nick Racker, the captain of the Generals, so exactly what you expect out of your captain.
Of course.
There. As a faceoff and now a chance, here's Weber. He'll jump on it. So we play 4-on-4. As the puck goes to the point, Levkov will send it in. But Kaminsky jumps on it. Now a stretch pass looking for Pizzamenti. Pizzamenti takes it around the net, but he gets bumped off the play by Wojciechowski. And Weber overskates the puck, but now Teräväinen will jump on it. Levkov will chase. DeShepper puts him into the boards. As the puck will come out to center, Kovalev jumps on it. And now here's Wojciechowski, and now some extra curricular behind the play. And now a 2-on-1 chance, a 3-on-1. Pizzamenti to DeShepper, back to Pizzamenti, and a save by Hirschfeld. So a 3-on-1 chance that doesn't result in anything for the Generals. Another scoring chance gone by the boards. And now a chance in front here, taking it to the goal. And that was Donovan, and I think he might get a penalty here for goalie interference.
That's probably what's going to happen most likely, which for the hat tricks, it's not the most best scenario you want to be in here, is in, you know, back-to-back penalties.
And I guess they're not going to get. I thought, look from here for sure that Donovan rammed right into Rieger. No call. So we continue to play 4-on-4 here. Now Bacon winds one up from the point. Blocked by Kaminsky. And now another 2-on-1 chance here. Pizzamenti being trailed, but Holiday jumps in and they score! Oh. It's Kaminsky! Scores a 4-on-4 goal. Jacob Kaminsky, what a shot by the glove of Trey Hirschfeld. And it's a 3-2 game. The Jens make it a one-goal game.
And that was a beautiful play by Kaminsky there. His fourth goal of the season. I mean, the hesitation at first, you know, got the hat tricks off guard on that, and he was able to get that right up and under. And we now have ourselves a game as the second goal of the second period.
And that's a big goal for the Generals with 4:53 left to go. 4-on-4, plenty of space out there, and the Jens able to capitalize on that. And now a giveaway behind the net and a wraparound attempt that was shut down by Rieger. Now to the point, a nice keep in there by Madzy. And now back to the point, Bacon has plenty of room. He'll wind one up, saved by Rieger, and the rebound came out loose and he jumps right on it.
Rieger has been playing exceptional as goalie here for the Generals in the second period, being able to stop these second chance opportunities. I mean, earlier in the first period, that was not the story for him. It looks like he's changed things up and he got into that mindset and has been quick to jump on top of the puck when it comes near him.
And Espen Rieger, a big reason why the Jens are still in this hockey game, it being only a one-goal game at 3-2, as Deacon Moore will look for a cross-ice pass just out of the reach of Kaminsky, and it will be icing.
And here we are, back to 5-on-5 hockey after 2 minutes for both the Generals and the Hat Tricks.
Indeed, and always a treat to watch some 4-on-4. A lot more space, as we mentioned, out there.
And a lot better opportunities, too, for the Generals. And it looks like they capitalized on that,
absolutely,
which is great for them.
Kovalev won the draw, and the puck goes in the corner. A nice hit there. And a giveaway by Clark. And now in front of chance. What a save by Rieger, coming off his line to rob Kovalev. And now we're going to get a penalty, I believe, behind the play. I think Kovalev's going to go for a rough.
And Rieger, he looked like Superman out there as he jumped right in front of that puck and threw his body out there on the line for that save. And a big reason, like you mentioned earlier, is that The reason why they're in this game is because of Rieger.
Absolutely. And folks, this is why I'm not an official, because once again, I am wrong about a penalty that I thought was behind the play. It looked like Kovalev had threw a punch at, I believe it was Kaminsky, Jacob Kaminsky.
I saw some gloves on that ice, so that's what I thought was going on too. So it wasn't just you.
And the puck almost hits the scoreboard there at center ice. There's a great chance. And Teräväinen tried jumping on the puck there, but it was knocked away by Deacon Moore. Now the puck at center ice, and it comes back to Wojciechowski. Now Donovan tries to beat Moore to the puck, can't. But the Hatricks regain possession, and now give it up. Kaczynski tried dancing with it, but Donovan picks his pocket, and he'll dump it in on Rieger, who leaves it for Deacon Moore. Now Lebkoff has it at the point. He'll send it in behind the net, and Rieger will take a whistle. And now some jawing going on here between Lebkoff and Morelli at center ice. Morelli got away with a little slash there. It wasn't little. It was a big hack there. But the officials will let them skate to the benches. A little jawing going on as Lebkoff chirping at somebody over there on the Jens bench as he skates back to his. And now Holiday and Peyton Felix on the faceoff. It's won by Felix, but Mastromoni jumped on it and put a shot in to Rieger's glove, and he'll take another quick whistle. So Holiday on the draw. Goes into the corner, Mastromoni. Now Pizzamenti. He'll jump on it, take it behind his own net, looking for Dylan Dent. Now Racker jumps on it. The captain brings it past center ice into the zone, and we'll just flip it in on Hirschfeld to get a whistle. But 2:52 left to go here in the second period.
Seems like it's been a long second period here. A lot of icing back and forth and a lot of stoppage in the play. I mean, both teams really kind of taking it slow after a very fast and explosive first period. Now it's just mellow and slow, and they're taking their time trying to, you know, as the Hatricks are trying to extend their lead, but that's not really working in their favor because the Generals have two goals in the second period.
Absolutely. A lot of stoppages in this period. We had about, I'd say, four icings within the span of a minute. As the puck goes behind the net, Pizzamenti will trip it up the wall. Racker now has it. They'll get it up to Peyton Felix. Felix past center ice, gets bumped by Kovalev. Now there's a battle for it on the half wall. Thrown in front, just out of the reach of Pizzamenti, but DeShepherd will jump on it. DeShepherd throws one towards the net, got blocked away. DeShepherd with another good pinch in, gets bumped there by Bacon in the corner. And the puck slowly coming out towards the point. Nick Racker establishing position there, able to keep it in. Now Racker finishes his check on Kovalev. But here come the Hatricks, and they'll dump it in there as the Shepherd will be back to get it behind his net. He'll throw it up the boards. And now Oberon throws it in the middle looking for Clark. A nice play by Kaczynski. Now Oberon jumps on it. He comes down the wing. And Lebkoff finishes his check on him hard into the boards. Now Donovan can't get it past Loftus. Loftus gets it past the blue line in a giveaway. Clark in front, he scores! James Clark capitalizes on a giveaway by the Hatricks, and we are tied at 3 with 1:20 left to go here in the second period.
That was a beautiful shot by Clark, his 17th goal on the season. That was a high one. Looks like it was right above his head there, and it was able to capitalize on that goal. And the entire possession here for about a minute was on the far side of the ice, and the Generals able to capitalize, and now we got ourselves a game here as it's tied by 3, and all 3 of the goals have come in the second period. So strong presence here, and hoping to carry that momentum over the next minute and the other 20 in the third period.
And that is James Clark's team leading now 17th goal of the season. And it's a huge one that ties the game up here late in the second period. So the Jens pull even with just a minute left here in the second period. Puck goes in on Rieger. Peyton Felix gets it to Pizzamenti. Pizzamenti on the half wall. It's in the feet of Pizzamenti, and now the puck goes around the net. The Hattricks jump on it there first. Let the Jens come out with it. It's Racker. And now a 3-on-2 chance here for the Jens. Racker to Moore. Moore shoots just wide past the glove side of Hirschfeld. Now Kaminsky jumps on it as he's bumped there. And now a chance here for the Hattricks, but getting back on Pizzamenti. But a centering pass, and they score! So right after the Jens tied the game, a 2-on-1 chance the other way, and the Hattricks will tie the game. And that is Jake Oldham who ties the game here with 13 seconds left to go in the second period.
That's Oldham's second goal of the season. And, you know, on that play, they had the opportunity. They had more men on that side of the ice. And they just got right past Rieger, who's been having an exceptional second period. And this had one just slipped right by him on that play.
Yeah, nothing Rieger could do there. And it was a great setup by Drew Goodman, who got it over there to Oldham. And it looks like a penalty is going to be taken here. It's going to be Westendorf, who will be sitting in the box, I'm assuming, for an unsportsmanlike conduct penalty, as there was some jawing going on after the goal. And Nick Racker also back in the box for the Jens, so we're going to play another 2 minutes of 4-on-4 here. Westendorf in the box for the Hattricks, for both for unsportsmanlike conduct, as we're underway for the third period, as Wojciechowski will play it up to center ice to Kovalev, and then it's sent right back in, and a funny bounce there off the kick blade. So the Hattricks back on their own end. Wojciechowski plays it across. Now here he comes. He'll skate it into the zone. Almost offside. He throws it on Rieger, and he had to kind of handcuff him there, but he's able to jump on the rebound and take a whistle.
Aggressive start early on. I mean, only a few seconds into the third period, and another shot for the Hattricks. So they have 23 on the game. That one looked like it hit the crossbar there or something like that before Rieger could get onto that. And Rieger's been busy in the first period. Had some quiet moments in the second, but coming out strong here in the third as he's had some great saves.
So Oberon on the faceoff against Weber. To the left of Espen Rieger. Hattricks win the draw, shot on net right into the gut of Rieger. So clean faceoff win there by Weber. Got it back to Teräninen.
Rieger has had some cat-like reflexes in the second period and carrying over into the third, something he was lacking in the first when they got that 2-0 lead early on for the Hattricks.
Reshepa rims it around out of the reach of Peyton Felix. Now Weber has it. Try to get it on the half wall to Bacon. Now Weber coming in from the point. Is Bacon the defenseman down low as him and Weber switch? Weber out at the point. But now here's a chance for the Generals up the ice. Peyton Felix dangling around, keeping the puck into the corner. Now he gets it out to the point to Deacon Moore. Moore rifles one, but it's kicked aside by Hirschfeld into the corner. Peyton Felix now jumps on it. He'll take it around. Gets bothered there a little bit by Mastry. The puck back into the corner. Bacon on it. He'll chip it up to Weber. And Teräninen gets it back into the corner to Mastry. And Oberon bumping Weber off the puck there. He'll take it down the wall here. Looking to the net. Backhands one. It goes off the side of the net, it looks like. Deacon Moore there keeps the puck in. Now Pizzamenti tried to jump on it, and now he will as the puck was sent back to center ice. Pizzamenti looking for DeShepherd. They flip it into the zone, but right onto the stick of Levkov. Levkov now plays it up to Kovalev. Kovalev, and his stick goes flying as he pulled a little curl and drag move, but he put the hat tricks offside.
A lot of back and forth action right now. Limited puck control from both teams as they trying to get it past the neutral zone and trying to get it onto the respective sides, but back and forth action.
And Payne Felix wins the draw. And yeah, that's should have been a hand pass, but not going to call it. No icing as Kovalev jumps on it, looking in front. Just wide on the chance there by Cullinan, one of the goal scorers today for the hat tricks. Now Kovalev circles back in his own end. Hits it on the wing. Now here come the hat tricks. A nice move in front, and they score! A little curl and drag move, very patient with the puck, was Cullinan, and now he has his second of the day. And it's once again a two-goal lead for the hat tricks, 5-3 with 17:30 left to go here in the third period, so a good start for the hat tricks.
It looks like for the Generals, there's really nobody else helping out Rieger on that Cullinan goal as he gets a second as of today, as you mentioned. And something that if you're the Generals, you cannot let this lead extend any further. You're going to have to come back aggressive offensively and not be so passive, because you cannot let the hat trick score again, because this game might be out of reach for them at that point if it does come to that situation.
So Cullinan getting his fifth and sixth goals of the season. Nick Cullinan, that was a great little move there he put on. Very patient with the puck. Worked his way towards the middle in between the hash marks and just flat out beats Rieger clean. And now we have a little bit of a discussion here. It seems like one of the coaches for the hat tricks is not too pleased with the officials. It looked like there was some jawing going on after the goal in the corner, and the officials trying to sort things out here,
trying to get some control, because this is the second time that's happened after a hat trick's goal where there's been a little extracurricular activity in the scuffle towards the end.
Now Kaminsky gets knocked off the play there by Levkov. Now the other Kaminsky will keep it in at the line. Now Clark tried to weave his way through the faceoff dot. Gets the puck knocked off his stick, and now there's a battle for it on the half wall. Now Levkov chases it behind his own net. Looks up ice. Will send it off the glass. No icing. And now Oberon will trip it up, but intercepting it is Holiday. Holiday, good puck possession, but he loses it. But then he gets it back as Donovan chipped it to him. Now here's Donovan. Chases it in the corner. Oberon doing a good job there, and some help from his defenseman Kaminsky. And now it's a battle behind the net and kicked loose by Donovan as Rogers gets it out to the point. And now the puck goes around, and Kaminsky had no idea where it was. And now behind the net, Oberon, it's picked off by Mastroni. He'll fire in a block shot by Kaminsky, so a nice block there as Mastroni had a great chance there, almost point blank. Now Holiday has it back behind the net, centering pass to Mastroni. He loses his stick. Now Wallace, he'll throw it towards the front of the net. Nobody there, fortunately, and the Jens will throw it all the way down. And we're going to get a penalty here from behind the play. I didn't see what happened, but Nicholas Oberon is down, and he is not getting up.
Very aggressive from the hat tricks, it seems like, in this third period. Lots of bodies going up against the glass, and a lot of emotions here in the third period as they have a 5-3 lead, and something that could cost them a little bit is if they get into the penalty situation too much in this third period and give the Generals a little bit of an advantage.
And scary play there. He couldn't see what happened, but it's taking Oberon some time to get up, and he's going to need some assistance. And it'll take him to the bench. He'll get applause. Or correction, that was not Oberon. My mistake. That was indeed Tyler Kaminsky. Looked like a 13, not a 17. But clearly a penalty, and now the officials are discussing inside the officials circle there. So you gotta wonder if this could end up being a major penalty, which would be huge for the Generals here.
And if it is indeed, the Generals need to start capitalizing sooner rather than later. Still plenty of time with 15 minutes, but we all know how 15 minutes can fly by in a blink of an eye. So they just need to be aggressive on the offensive end and trying to be able to get some shots on the goal, because they haven't been able to in this third period within the first 5 minutes. And
it is indeed going to be a major. Carson Holliday seemingly has been awarded a game misconduct, which means a 5-minute power play here for the Gens, and they can score at will. It's not an expiring penalty until it hits zero, so you can score as many goals as you want here, and this is going to be huge for the Gens to capitalize. And it's going to be Wesley Westendorf who served the penalty. And you got to wonder if Holliday there is going to face discipline from the league for that. Because usually when you see guys get a game misconduct, there's more discipline to come after the fact.
And with these 5 minutes, that's plenty of time for the Generals. Unfortunately, though, it hasn't really worked out well in their favor on the power play, because they have not been able to convert on the several that they've had. So 5 minutes is plenty of time for them to get something going, because they need some spark, and I believe this could be it. Seeing one of their players go down, like Kaminsky, they should add some fuel to the fire and light something up for them here.
5-3 with 15:40 left to go. Power play for the Gens. It's a 5-minute major. To Carson Holliday, and now a chance for Kovalev, who almost had a breakaway, and it was a good defensive play by DeShepherd. Now Kovalev comes up the half wall with it, so the Gens a little sloppy to start this power play. Not what they want, but they are able to re-corral it, and Caden Felix tries bringing it into the zone, and then the hat-tricks ready there. It's in the neutral zone and are able to get it all the way down as Rieger leaves it off for Moore. Moore leaves it off for Felix. Felix building up speed through the neutral zone. Stays with it, comes down the wing, takes it to the net. Felix in front, and the puck went in. They score. They're going to count it. Felix went hard to the net. It looked like he bumped into Hirschfeld. Hirschfeld is not happy, and I don't blame him. But the Gens back within one as they strike quickly with 4:14 left on the major penalty. So it's a 5-4 game now.
And that's exactly what they needed to do. I mean, Felix, what he was doing was the stick work there on that play, kind of bobbing and weaving, getting his way to the goal. And it seemed like he did get a little bit of contact with the goalie and Hershovitz. And, you know, that's just one of those things where the officials just let that one slide. It looked like that one time. I mean, and now we have ourselves a game still, like you mentioned, 4:14 the power play. So able to convert again and maybe another one after. So this is the time where they're going to need to do so if they want to tie the game or take the lead with about 14 minutes left in the third period.
And you can see the captain of the hat-tricks, Connor Levkoff, discussing with the officials,
trying to plead his case to see if they could.
And he has a case. I thought for sure that Felix definitely took away the ability for Hirschfeld to play his position there, but the Gens catch a break and it ends up counting as a goal. So Peyton Felix with the goal, and that'll be his 15th of the season as the Gens win the draw. Kaminsky, and now Clark The very speedy James Clark gets past the blue line into the zone. And Jens Sandekorn in front. Oh, what a save by Hirschfeld. It was a changeup, and that's one of those plays where you kind of have to react differently, but Hirschfeld flashes the leather on a great point-blank chance in front there for the Jens.
Man, Hirschfeld has been busy the second and third period so far, and he's been doing a great job so far in this game.
Rulli wins the draw, but the hat-trick's able to jump on it. And they'll send it back into their end. Levkov, the captain, will wind it up off the glass all the way down. Rieger gets it for Dylan Dent. Dylan Dent using his body well there is now... Kaminsky will have speed. Kaminsky dumps it in on Hirschfeld. A smart play there by Jacob Kaminsky to get an offensive zone faceoff with still 3:29 left to go on this major penalty.
And even if they get one more goal, or if they're not able to, they still got that one, which it puts them back into this game with plenty of time left in the game in the third period, a little over 14 minutes left to play.
Peyton Felix on the draw. The Shepherd is able to get it over to Moore. Moore pulls the trigger, pats it, Hirschfeld, rebound, they score! It's Peyton Felix again! His second power play goal on this power play. And the Jens have tied it. It's 5-5 with still plenty of time left on the power play.
Felix, I mean, it seemed like these goals happened back-to-back because, I mean, he got it great off the rebound. A good read, was able to tell the direction which a puck was coming from and just able to tap that right in and get right past Hirschfeld on that.
So Peyton Felix, another power play goal, and now that's his 16th on the year, so he has tied Deacon Moore for being second on the team for the season. And once again, as we said, there's still plenty of time left on this power play for the Jens to capitalize on.
And that was certainly a huge change of momentum, because once Kaminsky went down and now they were awarded the major power play, they got two goals out of it and able to tie it up.
There's a buddy in front, loose, and a diving save, rebound, they score! The Jens take the lead on the power play. It's DeShepherd who pots home the rebound. So that's three power play goals on the major penalty. The Jens certainly taking advantage, and they now have the lead 6-5.
And that's DeShepherd, his second goal of the season, and coming up huge in this power play and in this period, because now the Generals have the lead for the first time in this game, and no better time for this to happen in the third period. And we got ourselves an exciting hockey game here on Hockey TV.
And still, once again, plenty of time left here for the Jens on the power play. 2:45 as now Clark takes it in. Clark down the wing in front, and a save by Hirschfeld. The puck goes back to the point. Dylan Dent throws it towards the front of the net, and it's going to go out of play.
That was a good read, though. They were trying to get it right into the middle, possibly setting up a good opportunity for a right-on-goal shot, but it was just a little too high and was deflected going out of the play.
And good to see Tyler Kaminsky back out there at center taking the draw, who looked banged up. He was on the brunt end of that hit from Carson Holliday, who has been awarded a game misconduct, which has led to this five-minute power play for the Jens as Weber jumped on it there, but now here come the Jens back up the ice. Here comes Kaminsky. He'll shovel it in on the backhand. Clark will chase. He gets bumped in the corner there by Teräväinen. Jacob Kaminsky jumps on it. Cross ice to Oberon. Oberon dancing with it up against the boards. He'll shovel it in deep. Tyler Kaminsky chips it to Jacob Kaminsky. Now Tyler Kaminsky has it. Back to Jacob Kaminsky. Dylan Dent winds up a shot that goes just wide past the stick side of Hirschfeld. Clark now has it. As we approach 1:40 left on this power play, a major power play. as Dylan Dent rifles one that goes just wide over the net. And it's going to be a high stick. So the faceoff. Or did it go out of play? Unless it was a high stick on the hat tricks. I thought I saw the high stick signal given by the official.
It's a tough angle from where we're looking at. Right in the corner there. It's right out of our peripheral vision. But still, what I'm seeing with the Generals right now is a very aggressive play on this, on their end. And it looks like the hat tricks are on the short end of the stick here, no pun intended, when it comes to defense.
Now DeShepherd, who just put home the lead. Off the crossbar was Deacon Moore. As I just mentioned, the cross-ice pass D-to-D from DeShepherd. DeShepherd brought it home, the goal that put the Gens ahead, and that's just his second of the year.
And if they can keep it on this side of the ice, and they can chew the clock a little bit more, I think, you know, DeShepherd could have that go-ahead goal here, but still plenty of time for the hat tricks to come back with about 12 minutes left to play.
DeShepherd does now have 18 points on the season. There's a reason why he's on their power play unit. As now Peyton Felix. Oh, shoot. Blockered away there by Hirschfeld into the corner. Now the puck comes back out. DeShepherd able to keep it in. Goes cross ice to Deacon Moore. Moore looks. Goes back to DeShepherd. DeShepherd skating with it. Leaves it for Moore. Moore chips it into the corner. Peyton Felix on it. Felix bothered a bit there by Glebkov. Now in front. Pizzamenti. They score! Pizzamenti feeds Nick Wacker in front. The captain pots it home. It's a two-goal lead for the Gens, 7-5.
And that was a beautiful pass by Pizzamenti. I mean, that's his 17th assist on the season, and that was absolutely beautiful, right in the pocket and right where you need it.
Right in the breadbasket there in the wheelhouse for Nick Wacker, the captain. And Wacker potting home the goal, and the tables have now turned. It's the Gens who now have the two-goal lead. Nick Wacker with his eighth of the season on the power play. Still 40 seconds left to go here, so the Gens could pot home one more. That's four power play goals in the span of 5 minutes. And that's exactly what you want to do when you are on the other receiving end of a five-minute major. Take advantage of the power play. And now here comes the hat tricks.
And Hirschfeld's have had a very busy third period here because of the power plays. They're left hanging a little bit here with the four players instead of the five. But speaking of that, here we go. We're back to 5-on-5 hockey.
But the Gens doing as best they can nonetheless, completely capitalizing on the power play. And now the hat tricks will go on the power play. Looked like a slash maybe, or a roughing call against Dylan Dent, so he'll sit for 2 minutes unless the hat tricks can score on the power play. So this is a big power play now for the hat tricks after being up two to start this period and now finding themselves down two after that big 5 minute power play. The major who was given to Carson Holliday. And so now a chance for the hat tricks to get back in the third period here as all the momentum has completely shifted. It draws one, Levkov gets it to Kovalev. And a little bit of a bumpy pass there. Levkov has to take it back to center. Now Levkov skates past center ice, gets it to Kovalev. Nikita Kovalev with it. Gets pressured on the half wall. The puck comes out loose. DeShepherd jumps on it and he'll send it all the way down. Hirschfeld, and now good job by Nicholas Oberon to get in front of the captain Levkov there. Forced Hirschfeld to get rid of it. And now the puck fired back in on Hirschfeld. He'll leave it off for Dubé. Now the puck all the way down and an icing taken by the hat tricks. So the Jens will take that as they get an offensive zone faceoff shorthanded with 9:51 left to go here in the third period, up two goals.
And this is, you know, if you're the Hattricks, what you need to do is capitalize. And this is kind of what the opposite of what they're doing on this power play here, letting the Generals have the offensive faceoff here. And this is the wrong territory you want to be in here, because the Generals are down one extra player.
And the Hattricks win the draw. Now Levkov to Kovalev. He'll chip it too far past Teräninen. And firing it into the bench there is Deacon Moore, and a little bit of collision after the whistle. And the Hattricks will change up their power play unit with 1:08 left to go on their power play.
And something certainly needs to change here for the Hattricks with the last 68 seconds here in the power play. They need to be strong offensive here and very aggressive to see if they can try to at least make this a one-goal game in the next minute.
So Tyler Kaminsky wins the draw. Deacon Moore gets it to Clark. Clark looked like he could have had a breakaway, but he stumbled a little bit. Pulls up nonetheless, takes a shot. It's blocked into the legs of Masdy. And Masdy will take it behind his own net. And now here comes Donovan. And picking the pocket there was Kaminsky. So good job here by the Jens penalty killers, and Kaminsky will go off for a change. And now Jacob Kaminsky gets his pocket picked. Here's Rogers closing. That one might have hit the crossbar, and it goes out of play. So the Jens dodge a bullet there on the great chance by Nick Rogers. And Rogers does have 8 goals this year for the Hattricks, so that leads the team.
And if you look at both leaderboards for the teams, it's a whole 180 for the Generals. I mean, they're leading scorer has 17 goals on the season. So completely different team, two different teams here. But in the last few games, it's actually the Hattricks who have the momentum going forward.
And now Rogers gets taken down. Just 15 seconds left to go on the penalty. And now Kaminsky mishandles it behind the net and he loses his stick. So a de facto 5-on-3 here for about 5 seconds. And now wide open in the slot is Maher. And he'll throw it towards the net. But we're all even here as the Jens kill it off. A huge penalty kill there for the Generals. As now the puck goes in behind the net. Rieger leaves it off for Kaminsky. Puck goes just past to Schepper. And the puck goes into the corner as Wojciechowski plays it around. And a big hit in the glass. Looks like it came a little bit loose there on that collision. And now the puck fired off the linesman's head and into the bench of the Generals. And they might want to go take a look at that glass over there, as it looked like the bolt came out of it. We already had glass problems earlier today, and we had to switch rinks.
Led to about a 30-35 minute delay prior. It was supposed to start at 4. I don't know if we started until a little bit later, 4:30, between 4:30 and 4:50 when the game actually started. So, yeah, I mean, a lot of problems here with the glass in today's game.
And now a turnover here is Kaczynski throws one off the crossbar, and that one goes up and out of play. A great chance there for Jacob Kaczynski right at the faceoff circle. Just wasn't able to get it low enough under Hirschfeld.
Yeah, and, you know, we talked about how this Generals team is very aggressive in the first period, but it was actually the other way around. They were very passive and slow, and it was actually the Hattricks who came out firing on all cylinders. And now it's just a whole different team here in the second and third period. They really stepped it up in order to make this comeback win here.
Really on the faceoff. Kovalev, though, wins it. But right into the stick of Kaczynski, couldn't hang on to it. Now Morelli comes in the corner. Gratz on it. Now here's Gratz. to Kaczynski. Kaczynski takes it behind the net. Looks in front for Gratz. Pulls the trigger. But the puck bounces off his stick. And now a chance the other way here for the Hattricks. Circling around the net, and the net goes off as Kaczynski slid into the goal, and it came off his moorings. And now here we have some extracurricular after the whistle, and in comes in, I think that was Deacon Moore, and now we got a little bit of a Donnybrook going on in the down in the corner here. So we'll see what the penalties look like after this.
Certainly saw a few haymakers in that mix over there. I mean, this is, like I said before the period started, this is going to be a very aggressive third period, and it certainly shows up to be that.
It was Teräninen and Deacon Moore that were going at it. Moore jumped in a little late. It looked like initially it was Kaczynski that was going at it with him. So we'll see what the laundry is getting sorted out here. With 7:09 left to go in the third, the Jens have a 7-5 lead. And it's been an up and down day for the Jens. They had a bit of a slow start in the first period, and they have climbed their way back. And it looks like Deacon Moore has been sent off for the rest of the game. So I'm assuming that he's receiving a 10-minute misconduct, which does not result in a change of manpower. Unless, of course, he was also given a roughing penalty, which I assume will happen after that scrum.
And this certainly is going to change, you know, the momentum, because we saw that earlier with the Hattricks when they had that 5-minute penalty, and that was when the Generals scored 4 within that 5 minutes. And now here we are. This could change the entire rest of the game, because there's only 7 minutes left in the third period. And if the Generals, if they, depending on what happens when the officials sort this all out, this could be a game changer.
Yeah, and I have a funny feeling that the Jens might end up being shorthanded here, because it looked like they had kind of 2 guys on one there.
Mm-hmm.
But we'll see what happens as some conversation. Looks like it's peaceful, at least, going on here in the Generals' defensive zone. So there's no time posted yet on the scoreboard. And right now, it looks like there's 5 guys out on the ice in the defensive zone for the Generals. And right now, there's only 2 for the Hattricks, but that's not going to stand. That would be interesting to see a 5-on-2.
Yeah, that'd be very interesting. I'd hope at least they capitalize on something. It's lopsided, it's dead. But I mean, a lot of conversations going on here. I think they're still trying to figure out what they're trying to do here. If it's going to, how long the penalty is going to be. And it looks like the officials are talking all over with the Hattricks coach over there, one of the coaches over there on their bench. And
yeah, Matti Teräinen is going to head off. So I think they're just going to give both guys each a 10-minute misconduct, and they'll call it a day, which is the right decision.
Mm-hmm.
You know, both guys going at it in the corner. Mm-hmm. We saw Moore skate off already. I assume that's what's going to happen.
Yeah, the next few minutes are going to be very pivotal for the Hattricks if they're trying to come back here after being up 2 for what it felt like most of the game. The Generals now have their first lead of the game, and they have a 2-goal lead, and this could certainly change. I mean, we've seen tide swings change throughout this game. I mean, it's been an up and down roller coaster for the Generals, and for the Hattricks, it stayed pretty constant up until this third period.
So it will be 5-on-5, which indicates the 10-minute misconduct, as we mentioned. 7 minutes left to go here in the third period. The Jens up 2. Wojciechowski brought it in offside, as still in the zone was pulling in for the Hattricks. So the faceoff will come in the near side here in the neutral zone.
Nonetheless, I mean, this third period has certainly been rowdy, but other than that, the game has been pretty clean. I mean, this is a great hockey game between the Hattricks and the Generals.
Absolutely, a tremendous back-and-forth hockey game we've seen here today. and the Shepherd fires it into his own bench. So the faceoff will remain in the defensive zone here for the Jens. But it's been all Jens in the third period here, out shooting the Hattricks 42-27. Many of those shots coming on a 5-minute major power play, as we mentioned. Now Oberon chips it up. Clark jumps on it, a 2-on-1. Clark throws it on net, and Hirschfeld didn't know where it was. Now DeShepherd shoots from the point, and a save by Hirschfeld, and he'll take a whistle.
That was a good rebound on the outside. Trying to reset the offense there, but Hirschfeld came in big there. Hirschfeld came in big with the good save there. I mean, he's had a busy day on that side of the ice, especially in the third period when shots were coming at him left and right. But, I mean, he had a really good first period.
And we've seen the ability of James Clark today, who's just been using his speed. He's been all over the ice in a good way. He's brought it home, his team-leading 17th goal, which tied the game late in the second. It is now the Jens will send it all the way back down. This will be icing. A lot of icings in this tilt today.
Certainly, and that came in the very long, what it felt like, second period. And here we are, about under six minutes, left in the third period. And I mean, we've seen several icings so far, several stoppage and plays due to little scuffles here and there. So I mean, it's going to be a long 6 minutes of hockey.
The Jens win the draw. Vitsky will get it out, and this will go all the way back down, and it will be icing, another icing. That's been the word of the day.
It certainly has. I mean, it's been only about 10 seconds, and here we are with another icing play, so a lot of stoppage and new lineup changes here for the Generals.
The Jens will send out Kaczynski with Gratz and Morelli. Morelli wins the draw. Puck goes behind the net. Kaczynski throws it in front. But Kovalev was the only one there. And now a 2-on-1. Here's Kovalev streaking down the middle. And a big save by Rieger. And Nikita Kovalev is a very high-skilled player. So a big save by Espen Rieger. He does it yet again as the Jens ice it once more. But that is a huge save with 5:26 left to go in the third period. That makes it a one-goal game. And there's still plenty of time left. So Espen Rieger, for sure, keeping his team with the two-goal lead, preserving it here.
Yeah, and Kovalev, I mean, it was just him and Rieger one-on-one, and those two, and Rieger got the better end of the stick on that one because he had a great save, and he's been coming up big and late in the second and here in the third period.
Now Kaczynski tries to win the battle. Kaczynski throws it just in front. Now the puck battled for it on the half wall. Rogers jumps on it, throws it off the bench, all the way down. Not enough for icing. As Dylan Den had it, but now it goes to the point. Now DeShepherd chaps it off the boards. DeShepherd corrals it as the Jens make a quick change. And another icing. As the Jens are making a fire wagon and change there and just couldn't get their guys out on the ice in time to receive a pass.
It's going to be a very interesting 4 minutes left to play. I mean, it's been back and forth all day too. I mean, and this third period's been a lot more icing than back and forth. I mean, we've just been seeing the puck just go back and forth very slowly here in the third period.
Winning the draw, and they score! That's Donovan with an absolute missile from the top of the faceoff circle. And it's now a one-goal game with 4:34 left here in the third.
I mean, that was just right off the bat, too. I mean, no hesitation whatsoever. Donovan saw his opportunity to score and got right past Regan, who we were just praising about his great saves that he's had all day, but just let another one slip right by him. And this is a very high-scoring contest here. It's 7-6. Generals have the lead, but Patricks are looking to come back.
And that was a great face-off win there by Dylan Weber to get it to Colby Donovan, who pots his fourth of the season. So still plenty of time left here for the Hattricks to tie this game, as they still have it in the Gen zone as Butkoff lobs it in. Now Racker, here comes Felix, a chance for a hat trick, in alone. He shoots, he scores! That's a hat trick for Peyton Felix. And the Jens strike back quickly. They're back up two with 4:07 left.
Felix has had a great third period. I mean, two of his first goals came with a major power play. Now here, another one to kind of put a little bit of cushioning on this two-goal lead that they now have. And Felix having himself a day with the hat trick.
And I was going to say, I'm a little disappointed that nobody threw a hat, but it wouldn't be any point because of the netting that goes around the top here. But Felix with three goals today, two on the power play, and that's a huge goal for the Jens as they go back up two. It's 8-6 here. So Felix getting his 15th, 16th, and 17th goal today, and now he has tied James Clark for the team lead.
I mean, it's just been a great day for the Generals and their top scorers coming in big when it matters. And Deacon Moore, I think his absence in the later part of this third period has affected the Generals a little bit up until that Felix goal that kind of gave them some life back.
Not very much do you see a 8-6 hockey game anymore these days, but we have certainly had the treat of that today. And a tremendous back-and-forth game. And now here comes Kaczynski down the wing. He looks in front, looking for Gratt. Puts a backhander on Hirschfeld. Who's in front? Oh! And the Rui just missed that one with a gaping net in front of him. A chance to put the game away there.
Looked like it came off the stick in a weird angle, and that was an unfortunate play because, like you said, that game, the game would have been over after that goal.
And Donovan almost had a 2-on-1 there, but he couldn't handle the puck. It is now Weber will move it up. And you got to wonder at what point here the Hattricks will pull goalie Trey Hirschfeld to get an extra attacker out on the ice as we approach 2.5 minutes left to go here in the third. Clark throws it in front. Another save, Hirschfeld. Now Donovan leaves it off for Madzi. Madzi goes D to D to Lepkoff. Lepkoff to Mastroni. They'll chip it off the glass as the Hattricks get a quick change. We're approaching the 2-minute mark here in the third period.
The Hattricks need to attack fast now. This puck is staying on their offensive, on their defensive side, and you need to start doing something to get them into a scoring position here.
Mastroni carries it in. And a look for Hirschfeld to go in front. A great save by Rieger. Espen Rieger, another huge Tendel save. Keeping it a one-goal game. Or excuse me, a two-goal game. It would have been a one-goal game. And there's still 1:42 left.
And time's ticking away for the Hattricks. If they need to do something, they need to do it now because there's not much time left and the Generals are coming out heavy on the offensive side and staying down on that end, but now it's the defense stepping up for them.
And now Trey Hirschfeld out at the hash marks, and there he goes for the extra attacker. But right as the Gens get it out of the zone, so the Hattricks skating with six here, 6 against 5 with 1:26 left to go, down two. Rieger comes out of his net and gives it away. Now in front, he had a great reactionary save. Now Kovalev in front, but what a play there by Dylan Dent to keep the puck out of the net. Great defensive awareness.
It certainly was. I mean, Rieger was a little too far outside of the goal. Could have had an opportunity for the hat tricks. But luckily, Dent came in to save the day, put his body out there to stop the puck from going in the goal.
He saved the goal there, for sure. And the Jens took a necessary icing there. They want to slow things down, and we're going to have a timeout here, I'm assuming, taken by the hat tricks, as they're running out of time here with just 1:10 left to go here in the third period, down two.
And if you're the coach for the hat tricks, what I would be telling them is you got to just start playing more aggressive. You need to start setting up better opportunities in front of the goal to possibly set up your teammates for something special here in the third period. Better passes and open looks will help them out to possibly bring this game within one or even tie the game with a little over a minute left to play.
Yeah, and you would think that the plan here for the hat tricks is to have bodies in front of the net, just shoot the puck, because they have to get one quickly, and it's not an impossible task. If you get a goal here right off the faceoff, if you can score, you know, even before the 40-second mark, you still have a chance to tie this game. So the Generals still need to be very aware and active in their defensive end, get in front of shots, take away passing lanes. They got to be strong in their defensive end here.
They sure do, and if they are strong in the defensive end, they'll just start chewing the clock away, because this defense certainly has stepped up when it needs to today. And you know, this game's very high scoring, and the thing is, though, it's not even offensive heavy. I mean, we saw this in the first period where the Generals were scoreless, you know, because it was great defense from the hat tricks. But I mean, it's just been a mix of both great offense and great defense.
Yeah, and even with a lot of goals being scored there, we still have seen tremendous goaltending on both ends.
Some fabulous saves from both goalies, and the score doesn't really justify for itself what the goalies have done today.
And the Jens win the draw, but Donovan's able to keep it in. Kovalev, fans on the dump-in. As we approach 1 minute left to go here in the third period, and almost giveaway there. And firing it was Dylan Dent. Oh, and there we go. And now we're going to have a scrum here as an accidental high stick. And tempers will settle down here. You can see why the hat tricks got upset. And
it did seem like an accidental high stick. The puck was up in the air and looked like they were trying to knock it back down, but ended up hitting one of the hat trick players.
I believe it was Dylan Dent. But the thing about this, which is interesting, is the rule states on a high stick that if it's on the follow through, then it's not a penalty. And although it had his stick up in the air, it was Obern who made the foul, and they're going to give him a penalty, which makes sense. And
I'll put him out for the rest of the game. I mean,
and DeShepherd's going to get a penalty here as well, too. And you have to think that one of the hat tricks players will get a penalty after that little skirmish.
Yeah, because, I mean, right after that high stick, you saw several hat trick players kind of jump right on top of him and start defending their play, rightfully so. But, I mean, with 50 seconds left in this game and the hat tricks being down, you can see why tempers are going to be, you know, high in the final seconds.
I don't think that it obviously wasn't intentional. That's just hockey instinct. When
right.
The puck's up in the air, you're just trying to knock it down.
They were making a hockey play on that. It wasn't anything intentional whatsoever, like you said.
So, and now we're getting some back and forth here between the linesman and the coach of the hat tricks over there.
I mean, I can see why he's upset about that. A very dangerous play if there was some connection there between the stick and one of the players. And luckily, there was nothing too serious here in the final seconds.
So, a lot of long stoppages here in today's game. We've had some skirmishes with some penalties, including, as we mentioned, the 5-minute major issued to Carson Holliday, which ultimately gave that, or led to the surge by the Generals. They scored 4 goals on the power play, 2 of them coming from Peyton Felix. And Felix later on potted the hat trick in this period on a breakaway goal.
It's just going to be interesting to see how the momentum, it could shift, possibly. You know, the hat tricks could be a little upset about this, and they could see this as a way to really add fuel to the fire. They're down by 2 goals, 50 seconds left. It is possible to see this happen, but the Generals' defense, they need to be, on par for what they've been doing all day, especially in this third period.
If it holds up a stands here with 2 guys in the box with the Gens, then it's going to be a 5-on-3, and it's going to be a 6-on-3 now, obviously, because Hirschfeld is on the bench. They have pulled the goalie for the extra attacker. So, yeah, it looks like it's going to be a 6-on-3, a huge opportunity here for the Hatricks. And if they score here, then they still have a 5-on-3. Or excuse me, they still have a 5-on-4, but they can still get a 2-man advantage with the goalie pull to make it a 6-on-4.
And this is not the right situation for the Generals here. It's letting emotions come the best of them here in the last minute, because, I mean, this could cost them the game if the hat tricks capitalize on the power play.
This is the most important face-off of the game for either team. And some fans getting antsy here as...
I mean, 50 seconds left, under a minute, close game. You want to see some good hockey action here, because, I mean, this is some quality content right here. 8-6, high-scoring game, 50 seconds left, 5-on-3. I mean, this is a storybook ending here for the Hatricks if they can capitalize.
And it almost feels like an NBA game right now with it taking so long to finish the last minute. But finally, Felix and Weber will step into the faceoff circle, and the Hatricks with a huge faceoff win. Kovalev locking in, goes in the middle.
They're taking way too much time here off the clock. I mean,
Levkov. And now sending it down, keeping it in the skates is Levkov at center ice. And as you said, George, not much time here left for the Hatricks as Donovan brings it in.
Under 30 seconds, they need to score now more than ever. I mean, it's a 5-on-3. They should be able to get at least one in there.
And now a chance here for Levkov coming off the wall. Passes it down low. Doesn't matter. As time will wind down here, and that'll do it as a last chance in front by Weber.